What's up? I'm Jonathan, and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. In this video, we're going to be making this little box, which is a great starter to understand finger joints and box making with a laser cutter. Not only that, it's held together without any glue and won't come apart after the smallest tap. Let's go.
To make this little box, you need to understand the basics of laser kerf. For those that don't know what a kerf is, it's the material lost in any type of cutting process. I will make an in-depth video in the future about laser kerf. If that's already out, it's in the description. Every single material you cut will have a slightly different laser kerf. So first, decide on the material you would like to make this box out of. There are many ways to find your laser kerf. My preferred method goes like this. I cut a square, which on my computer is exactly 20mm by 20mm. Once cut, I make sure to mark the orientation of how it was cut. I do this because some lasers and materials cut differently depending on the cutting direction, i.e. the axis that the laser is moving on. From here, I use my calipers to measure this freshly cut square. I get 19.85 millimeters, and luckily for me, it's the same on both the X and Y. So to gather the kerf from this number, it's 20 millimeters minus 19.85, which is 0.15 millimeters. Now we need to divide this number by 2, as we are currently measuring the kerf that was taken away from both sides of the square. Doing this leaves us with 0.075 millimeters. With this new information, we now know we lose 0.075 millimeters of material on either side of our laser cut line. From this point, it's a little bit of trial and error. Now, I create 3 finger joint tests. One using a kerf of 0.07 millimeters, another one of 0.075 millimeters, and lastly, one of 0.08 millimeters. To create these test files, you can use your preferred vector creation tool. I like using Rhino 3D. I first create a simple finger layout, which each finger is a minimum of 10 millimeters wide, as long as the material is thick. If you go smaller than 10 millimeters wide per finger, you may skew your results due to the material giving way to the pressure of the adjacent finger. Once you have this basic shape, you can then add the new kerf value into the mix. For example, I'll be using my 0.08 millimeters in this one, as my other two tests are already made. To add this value, the way I go about it is I think of it as expanding each finger to fit into its joints. Everybody does kerf correction slightly differently. Some people like to apply it to just one side, some people like to do it to both sides. I personally like to do it to both sides. I select all the anchor points that need moving in one direction and move them all at the same time by my 0.08 millimeters. And then I go and do the same for the other side. One thing I like to do before putting this to cut is I add little kiss cut lines to them to distinguish one from another. Now that these first test pieces are made, let's get them cut. When it comes to the pressure fit results of this test, it's hard to explain what we're looking for, as it's something that will come with experience. But if I had to explain it, I'm looking for a good fit, not a tight fit. The reason for this is that once you have this kerf correction in the layout of a box structure, there are going to be many more finger joints fighting against your forces, along with other forces such as twist and warp of the wood. Thus, if you pick a joint that is too tight, there is a high probability that you can break your box or chip your wood while mounting it together. Out of my tests, I am happiest with the 0.08mm one. Now that we know this, I personally feel that the hardest part of most laser designs is now done. When it comes to box designing, there are two ways to go about things. Now that you know your kerf, you can use an automated solution like makerbox.io. Personally, I like to have full control over my box designs. So let's go make one. All you really need now is some dimensions for your box, plus some sort of idea of how you would like it to look. I'm going with an internal dimensions of 90mm tall, 70mm wide, and 70mm deep, with a very simple pull-up lid. In essence, all finger joint boxes are made of three parts, not including the lid, which are two A-sides and two B-sides with a bottom piece interlocking them all together. I'm going to show you my preferred box design style, which lets you hold a lot more weight inside of an unglued box. But please keep in mind that there are many different styles out there. To keep things as clear as possible, let's grab the two side pieces A and B. Let's add the unsized finger joints to each one. Now, before uniting them, let's resize the width of each finger where they need to be resized, using our Kerf joint value. An extra step to keep the box corners as flush as possible is to also resize the length of the finger by the original Kerf, that being 0.075mm. Once they're all resized, mirror these fingers over to the other side. Unite these, and that is sides A and B almost done. When it comes to joining the bottom to the sides, I prefer pin joints rather than finger joints. To make these pin joints, I'm going to first add two holes to both the sides. I'll be keeping the holes a minimum of 3mm from the bottom edge and taking note of the exact location of where I place them. I will also shrink these holes by the joint Kerf value, but I will make sure to keep a note of the original width. Now onto the bottom piece. I will be adding fingers or pins to fit into these holes, making sure that they are exactly placed and expanding and lengthening them by the Kerf values as well. Once these are united, the open box is designed. To finish things off, now let's get onto the lid. Taking a look at our box from the top view, we know that the internal dimensions are 70 by 70 millimeters. Starting with this 70 by 70, we will offset this by a value of 0.5 millimeters inwards. I do this because working with zero tolerance for moving parts is a little bit too risky sometimes. I'll also offset the 70 by 70 curve by 3.075 millimeters. This is the material thickness plus the curve. Finally, let's add a hole in the middle to lift the lid up from. Deleting the original Kerf, we are now left with a lid that would fit on top of the box and an interlocking piece that would go under this lid. You could glue these two together. However, to keep this build without glue, we are going to need to use pin joints once again. Let's add four small holes where these two pieces will be joined together with. Once again, shrinking the holes with the Kerf values and separating the two lid pieces. All that is left now for this design is some pins. These pins will be just over 6mm long, as it's going through two layers of 3mm wood plus the Kerf value on each side of the pin. So in total, these pins will be 6.15 millimeters long. As for the width, my original hole is 10mm, plus adding the Kerf joint value to each side gives me a width of 10.16 millimeters. Lastly, I will give the pins a small 0.5 millimeter fillet on the bottom side to make it easier to insert these pins into the holes in assembly. After copying the design over and the pins and nesting it all, let's get it cut out. Once cut, I give it a light sanding. Then it comes to assembly. It should all pressure fit together. Some very precise rubber malleting can come in handy for some extra persuasion if needed.
And following all of those steps, you will come out with a lovely little box. On top of that, you have learned how to master a kerf on one of your materials, and from there, the sky is the limit. I'll be showing you how to make this little box off the foundations of that, which is a little twist locking mechanism box. From there, you can get as complicated as 15-step puzzle boxes. All this is coming and much more, so make sure you subscribe, hit that bell icon. Thanks for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.